one man's junk is a electron's paradise.
You got the key! Nice! Look at you, you're an animal! You know that? I mean that in a positive way, of course. Anyway, while you were gone, I reached out to Ronnie from Edwin's gang. And they want their key back, but they also want the traitor who stole it dead. The good news is, we finally have a name for this genius. Bronx. Cute, huh?
Oh, they, have a bit of a history.
Edwin used to walk around with this giant fat cat perched on his shoulder. Right? He loved that cat. I bet you can guess what the Blood Eagles did, right?
That's right. They stole his cat, skinned it, and cooked it for dinner. Then they sent the bloody pelt back to Edwin in a sack.
Classy, right? Well, Edwin's her uncle, and someday when he kicks it, the gang goes to her. But the truth is, she's been leading that gang for years already. Having a tentative agreement with her is almost better than having a true handshake with him. You got it. I bet there's a stash around there too, so keep your eye out. You want a drink before you head out, or what? Edwin's had numerous setbacks with his gang lately. See, it's one of the bigger, low-key raider gangs around, but he's shedding respect. Making an example out of Bronx should help him put his house back in order. Not yet. He's, a free spirit. I love him dearly, but dependability, mindfulness, this plane of existence, yeah, not his thing. Ooh, I kind of like this. I got the bigger plan, I find the pieces, you execute them. I feel like some sort of mastermind. Good one.
has changed so much. So quickly.
Jackpot 2 square inches of
coming!
His eyes burn like fires in the night, and no enemy will escape his sight.
Divine light.
claim me.
Let's see. Start here. Ready for business.
There you are, Sage. How you feeling, pal?
No time to chit-chat, Beckett. Oh, I see you found a friend. Here for the party?
Nah, there's no party, buddy. My friend was the one who freed you. Do you remember?
Remember? Yeah, sure. I saw it first, felt it last. Good times. Oh, we're gonna need more cake.
I know he looks completely hopeless, but I promise you, it was worth springing him out of that place. Sage? Buddy? Pal? Friend? Can you hear me? Hey, I need your help. Now we're taking down the Blood Eagles. All of them. Now to do that, we need to cut off the head. You get me?
No. Not the head. Cut out the heart. The supply. At the cave. The cave. Ooh, spooky. Cave.
Okay. The cave. Got it. And Sage, you better come back later for the other questions, okay? And try to drink some coffee or something. You're killing me here. Mind me. Just taking it all in. Ronnie is gonna be thrilled to hear the betrayer is also dead now. I'm not wasting your time, I promise. Actually, he did give me some information. Valuable information. Okay, look, if we want to take out the Blood Eagles, we need to cut off the supply before we cut off the head. Now, the cave is where the Blood Eagles store their supply of buff out. And without it, well, it'd be harder to convert new members. Yeah, I hadn't thought of that. You know, come to think of it, the pills they force-fed me did look a little strange. I am glad I'm off that shit, that's for sure. Nah, he's not crazy. Just misguided and burned out. That's what messing with all these cults will do to you. See, the Blood Eagles are led by three vicious maniacs. The Blood, the Eye, and the Claw. And when I say maniacs, I'm being polite. I bet you want a drink as well, right? Free one. On the house. Sorry, no alcohol. See, regular Blood Eagles aren't the problem. Now, they're the symptom. I mean, yes, they're terrible, but the three bosses are clearly building an army. As they increase the doses of buff out, the addicted become worse. More violent, more terrible. We have to put a stop to that. I mean, yes. That's a fair...
Got a great place here.